Thank you. Brown's Patrick Toops and a MacLeod and Catherine Wiles. Let's hope the cast can get their tongues untied in time for their next number. And talking of getting untied, our next act brings a whole new meaning to the phrase escape the weekend. Please welcome the extraordinarily talented Mr. Mark Waghorn and his lovely partner in crime, Miss Catherine Jukes, as they bring to you an act of mystery, intrigue, and bondage.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is good to have you in the house tonight. Tonight, I am going to perform a daring act. My beautiful assistant, Miss Catherine Jukes, is going to put me in bondage. And I shall have 10 seconds to escape. Ladies and gentlemen, be prepared for this amazing act of talents tonight. We need 3 volunteers in the audience to make sure that I am not cheating. This is a very daring act, and we need some for you to make sure. The gentleman at the back, would you please light it up? And you, please light it up. Okay, ladies, guys, time for us. Oh, we have 4 people. We have 4 people. Let's make the double sure, doesn't it? I want you to make sure that we are not cheating, and to make sure that these chains really are locked.
Yeah.
be particularly pleased when I tell him that it is that demure and dimpling damsel, Miss Jellicoe. Here's a thing that wonderful horticultural ditty, Pansy Faces. Please welcome your own, your very own, Miss Jellicoe!
But the pretty boy.
Providing the glamour in that number were none other than that father and son act, the Mrs. Ian and Nathan Brown. One in the flower of his youth, the other one bold to see. Our next act is a man who for years has been trying to break into music hall. Unfortunately, the last time he tried, he was apprehended by a local constable and spent 6 months at Her Majesty's pleasure. He is a man who wants to make it big, so let's give him a helping hand. Here to tell us what it's like to be a member of the band, as only he knows how, our own, our very own, Mr. Melvin Hart.
As she brings us
a selection of your favourite music hall songs. So please, put your hands together for that sensational siren of song, Miss Catherine Wild!
Thank you.
courtesy of your press, alright? In third place, I would like to award the prize to this lady here. Would you like to come forward, please? In second place, I see this very fine gentleman over here. Come forward, please. And in first place, I think this lovely lady in black here with the fan. Yes.
Let's give them all a round of applause. And we'll see Daisy, Daisy, what's their leadership. My love this morning. Upon the
He vowed he would sing you the song that you love to hear, that you love to hear. Dead or alive. He vowed he would sing you the song that you love to hear. And your window at 6:45.
6:45?
6:45.
Thank you.
Welcome Miss Anna Landau as she sings with great gusto that wonderful song, I love to sing in opera.
Please feel the border.
chiefly attentive, if not avidly agog at our next question. This fine art piece has just completed a season at Billingsgate and Bishmark. Always a strong act. Yes, I am referring to a man whose artistry brings tears to your eyes. That man of mystery and melody, the ever irrepressible, Mr. Mark Whitehall.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, I would like to perform for you a musical extravaganza. There have been rumors that my musical prowess has not been given its full potential on the entertainment team. But tonight, all that is about to change. Some of you will know that I have had great experience in banding. I have been banned for playing the Matches band. And I've also been banned for playing in the International Staff Band. But tonight, for your delight, I shall play a solo with my own bare hands. And not only that, I shall play it blindfolded. I would like to introduce you to my pianist for the evening, the delightful Miss Anna Lamplauer. The brass band dates back to the early 19th century and England's Industrial Revolution. With increasing urbanisation, employers began to finance company bands to decrease the political activity, which preoccupied the working parties during their leisure time. Thus, the brass band tradition was founded. By 1860, there were over 750 brass bands in England alone, and my instrument was always an essential element to the rhythm and the pace of any well-constructed band. It has taken me years of practice to master the intense skill and technique that is needed. Tonight, I see as a pinnacle in my banding career. I studied my repertoire, and I've decided to play for you tonight a piece written by Mr. Arthur Sullivan in 1861. Sit back, be prepared to enjoy yourself, and to be uplifted and truly blessed.
Thank you.
inevitably to the last and final item. Though the thought of this brings sadness to the country, you can rest assured, ladies and gentlemen, that by the assiduousness of your attention and the aptitude of your applause, you remain incontrovertibly and incontestably the finest audience we have had this week. Thank you for your support. I shall wear it all. Have enjoyed it as much as we have, then it has been worthwhile. From all of us to all of you, thanks. And as we say good night and God bless, I invite you to join in a medley of your favorite songs, led by Miss Catherine Wiles and the whole company, but chiefly yourself. Take away this word.
Tune was a musical tune, but we sing different words too. So we start with Champagne Charlie, which of course what is now? Bless his name. He sets me free. Here we go.
Is still with the world.
song is Here's to Good Old Whiskey, Drink It Down. Now what is that, we say?
Drink the whiskey down?